you're happy, so I can't knock it. Just checked in our bags and everything went smoothly. We drove forever for 3+ hours and then we got to the train station and then went from there to the airport. So it's been kind of a journey. We've sort of been on the road since about 1:15 and it is 9:15. So just getting here was a whole process, but we're gonna go through security now. We're gonna go relax. Finally, it was a little stressful there for a few legs of the journey, but everything is coming together and our flight doesn't leave till 10:40, so we have a little bit of time to just kind of chill for a bit. So sit rep. We were 1 minute late to our gate, and they apparently, I don't know, must have given our seats away to somebody else or something, but they didn't let us on the plane, even though we were 1 minute late. It's kind of weird. So I guess we're going to fly straight to Aruba, spend a night there, and then take a puddle jumper the next morning to Curacao and resume our vacation. So we're sleeping in the airport tonight. Versus business class. It was kind of an expensive mistake. This sucked. All right, sit rep. It is 4:10 in the morning, and we have spent a grand total of 3.5 hours on the phone with American Express at this point. Thank goodness we've run into very helpful people, like the lady behind the monitor screen there. But, oh my gosh, word to the wise, do not ever book an airline ticket through a third party. Spend the extra little morsel more to go directly through the airline, and then if anything needs to be altered, it's just a very quick remedy.
It is not worth 5 times again.
Yeah, that's what the Platinum does, but Amex is on my shit list. Hey T, would you want to go to Lark Creek Grill and spend just a little too much time there to where we miss the gate? No, we actually get to watch the bitch flight attendant, or no, the bitch, whatever her job is. I don't know what she does.
Desperate.
Other than be a huge bitch. But she closed the door. We got to see her close the door, and then she wouldn't open the door and let us on the fucking plane. Bags are in Miami. They went on the flight that we were supposed to be on. So the next hurdle is, yes, once we get to Curacao, that's going to happen. We have that in the mix right now. It wasn't too much of a setback, thankfully. Worst case, we can just wear a swimsuit for the entire trip and undershirts, and then just kind of call it a day and then go swim in the ocean every day. And here we have Tiana behind me, observing business class. And since we missed our plane, you don't get to experience it. We made it through customs. We are right at the Hyatt, which is fortunately like literally across the street, which is going to make tomorrow very easy when we head to the airport. And then finally, our adventure to get to Curacao will be at an end. I'm just fortunate that we've gotten this far, and little baby boy has been a huge trooper. Oh my gosh. He exceeded our expectations.
Oh, it's a bed. I can lay down horizontally. Oh, it's been so long. We had to sleep at the airport with the baby, and this is just, oh my gosh.
Oh, I am very happy. Baby boy.
Let me go this way. There we are. I'm in frame now. We don't have any clothes. Hopefully our clothes are there waiting for us in Curacao, which it looks like they are based on the notifications that we were given by American Airlines. So we kind of cleaned our stuff in the sink and used a hairdryer, and I smell like a wet dog. So I don't know how well that worked. I think the baby's clothes turned out the best, fortunately enough. So we're like a 3-minute walk from the airport. We're gonna check out here. They said to get there early, so we're gonna get there early and probably sit around for a little while. But you know, it's better that than missing a flight, which is something that we don't want to do twice in one trip. We're gonna head out here and get to the airport and get on our little flying washing machine of an airplane. It's like not that big at all.